What's up, everybody? Yo! Today I'll be drawing the Russian alphabet. I think this is called Cyrillic, right? Yep, no spoilers today. This is a spoiler-free stream. Just gonna do some pixel art. Alright, so let's get the fonts open. Font. Alien font, small font. We're gonna need like a Russian font. Get rid of this timeline view. This ain't gonna be aminated. Ain't gonna aminate this. No way, no how. Liver Mortis, what's up? Cool name, man. Good afternoon to you, too. What's up, Teak? Yo, man. Congratulations once again on getting your game greenlit, man. Here's the small font. Here's the regular font. Here is the alien font. Oh, you know what? I guess I should make this part of the regular font. And the small font. How big is this already? This is only 256 pixels. We got plenty of room to add some more. Yeah, I think I'll just put the Russian font down here. You've been having a blast. You've been playing Songbringer. Ah, it's so good to hear. Both of those things. Kovarni, what's up? Kovarni, I'm doing the Russian font right now, man. So I got my Russian link. You found a bug? What? Tell me all about it. Yeah, you got the Windows version running? Right on, dude. Yeah, you got it all set up on Steam. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, so here's the bug. Now, let me check this out. Twitch. Yeah. Are you gonna walk through the wall here? Yeah, I've seen this one. I got this on my list. Oh, shit, I gotta actually... I don't know if this is on my list. People have been mentioning this like crazy. I don't think I've... Did I... Let's check if I put this on my list. I'm trying to get all these things that people mentioned this week fixed this week. Just to, you know... Show people I'm on top of it. You can count on me. You can count on Wizard Fu. Wizard Fu's got your back. These are the notes. These are all the other bugs I noted. Yeah, I guess I forgot to put this on my list. Damn. All right. Let's add a little bug here. Can walk through the wall in Fell's Cave. I swear I added this to the list. Yeah, I know this is on my list somewhere. But I lost it. Oh, well. Guess I'll just have two bugs to fix. Or when I fix this one, I'll have two crossed off the list. They'll be feeling so great. Okay, so in order of priority. Yeah, oh yeah, you tweeted that? Oh, okay, right, yeah. So did like a couple other people. It's weird. I don't know how y'all found that. You're some really, really thorough players. What's up, Zelda-dongs, ahoy! You met blue drones that freeze you in the room, then in second. Any way to kill them? Blue drones. What? Do you mean the blue, like, wizard-looking guys? Oh, Oh, dispensers. Oh, I know what you're talking about. The little blue flying there, yeah, the little midget ice guys. Yes, there's definitely a way to kill them. Just use any of your weapons. That nothing is restricted to kill those guys. Just swing your sword at them, throw your top hat, use the ghost sword. Oh, it looked like there was a door or a passage. Oh, okay. I was wondering about that. So what is it about that room that makes it look like there's a door or a passage? Let's go there really quick, just to like see. Trying to understand this because, for future game stuffiness, no, game. Other times when I go and create an entrance or an exit like this, I want to make sure it's clear. So crazy how it works on like everybody's save game too. What is like going on there? What is actually? Oh, it's like not even putting any. Oh, you know what? This will definitely look a lot clearer when it's actually as it's designed. There's supposed to be rocks right here covering this whole bit, and it'll make it look a lot less like there's an opening. So that's good. That'll be fixed. It's a pretty easy fix. You're trying, really? Yeah, that one was definitely not intentional. So wait, so Kavarni, what happens when you swing your sword? Can you kill them? I'll go fight a couple of them and show you what I mean. I think there's a few of them down here to the left. Bell's just kicking their ass. Bell, chill out. So yeah, you could just see some of these little guys. Some of them will freeze you, but some of them can't. So if you notice, some of them actually they're a little bit brighter. Those are the ones that can freeze you. But it really doesn't matter. If you just swing your sword, here, I'll even take off my weapons and stuff and other things that are making me powerful. No ghost sword. Two hits, huh? Oh, okay, well let me take off the do I have the chip? Boots, glove. Let's take off the glove. I have no chip. Why did they take two hits for you? Maybe because I had the ghost sword right there. So now I'm back to like regular swordiness. Yeah. Yeah, you could do it, Kobarney. You got it, man. Right, cool. So I'm gonna start on the Russian alphabet now.
A, B, V, G, D, Е, Ё,
Yeah.
Ж, З, И, краткое, К, Л.
Икрапке? You have a letter called Икрапке? You also had a dungeon in Dungeon 2 where I entered on the right, and there was one of those spawns on the left and one on the right. It was tough, but not impossible. What was your world seed?
M, N, O, P, R, S T U F H C Ч Ш Щ. Твердый знак. И.
Твердый знак. Wow, you got some long letters. That's a good question, Salad. Yours is Mortis? Okay, let me go really quick. Check it out. You're in Dungeon 2. There's no sound for it. Tverdi Miag. Verdi Miag. Wow. That's hard for me to say. So you said to the left? Oh, you said you entered on the left. Which way do I go? This one? It's gotta be it, huh? Wait, was this the one? Oh, yeah. Okay, so big secret here, too, with, like, enemies like this, bombs are really, really great. Oh, I just entered invincibility, sorry. Even with a lot of these guys on the screen. Right, so you got a couple bombs, you can work your way through rooms like this so easy. But yeah, as another secret to fighting these kind of things is you want to go and kill the spawner first. So these things right here, they'll keep spawning those enemies. Right? So you kill this and then it can't spawn anymore. Oh yeah, you use bombs. Yeah, bombs are great. And then, oh, also, Kavarni, if you have a cactus, a cactus really helps too. Yeah. Yeah, I've got a cactus here. So if you use a cactus, right? That's another little trick. If you use the cactus, you're invincible for like 3 seconds or so. So if you use a cactus, you can kind of like not get frozen. So I'll eat a cactus. And you can just start working them, especially you want to go make sure you focus on the spawner. So yeah, cactuses and bombs are like really, really powerful items. And your top hat, of course, is a really great one for fighting these swarms of enemies. Check it out. If I start over, the top hat's really great because the top hat can hit a lot of enemies and it goes on the way in and the way out. Especially with these little enemies, because the little enemies don't have much health. And the cactus doesn't do much, or I mean, the top hat doesn't do much damage, but it can really do a lot when you're fighting lots of enemies. So yeah, a lot of ways you can get through these guys. Yeah, it was. It must have been, because Dungeon 3 is probably your, with the World Seed Mortis, Dungeon 3 was probably the first swordless dungeon. You have a Nyaki's knock too?
Yeah.
Wow, these are great. Okay, I'm really excited that there's only 33 letters. That's not going to be too hard. Oh, and some of these I can reuse too. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Liver Mortis, that's a really tough boss. It's tough for me too, man. I played this a lot. So that the secrets to that are like you really got to get good at the blink, but you also want to really have a lot of health. So if you can have like over one row of health, like maybe a row plus a few more, and you want to have a full flask or three full flasks. If you could get all three full flasks, I don't know where they are actually right now, but I know you can get at least one flask. And then also you want to have at least one shield. You have six. you got it, man. You could do it. Bombs are kind of hard to use on that boss because she just like disappears everywhere. Top hat doesn't really do that much either. The blink, you know, you have to use it to get around that room. It's mostly like a sword thing. So you also want to have the chip and the chip and the glove really help. Both those things. The glove makes you attack twice as fast, and the chip makes you do like double damage. So if you've got those and lots of health, you should be doing a lot. It'll make it a lot easier to fight her. Okay, let's proceed. We get out my graphics tablet. Well, yeah, I'll start with the graphics tablet plugged in. But the first thing I need to do is actually start tweaking the font file. Unfortunately, there's no tool that makes this easy because I've got so many custom fonts like merged together and stuff. So I've got to go to font.font and just start hacking away at it like this. So we're going to need all these Russian letters. Is the Russian alphabet, is the A? Is the regular A code have its own Unicode character? Or is this like actually, when you type something in Russian, does it use like a regular A, or does it actually use a special Unicode character for the A? It looks like it does have its own Unicode character. A is the same? Oh, it's special? Maybe it's special and it's the same sometimes, depending on whether you... Yeah, for our Unicode. Yeah. Well, so that means that, okay, let's just assume that it is special, because I'll still use the same character in the pixel art, but in this font file, I'll want to actually set up a special character line for it. Cool, one little big boy, thanks, man. Kovarni also knows Russian, and he's the one doing the translation. Okay, so let's start with A. does that sound good? Start with the letter A. Oh man, are we gonna do capital and lowercase? Wait, do you have lowercase? You do, and they're different? Is it okay if I'm lazy and just do the uppercase? How important is it to have the lowercase letters? Just small versions, but this, yeah, there's definitely upper and lowercase English characters and everything else. There's like this and this, but it's really not that in the game. It's really not that important. At least it doesn't seem like. Oh, you think the lowercase letters are more important? Okay. All right, well, yeah, if they're more important, then let's do them both. Okay. Can't be lazy. All right, so we're going to need an A and a lowercase a. Whoops, oh, this is not the right font file. I'm going to get in trouble if I start editing this. I'm telling you, I know. I've done this before. I edit the wrong font file, then it overwrites, and I'm like, oh, blah, blah. It's in raw fonts, font.font. And I want to also open up all these other ones pretty much. So startup font. You're lazy. I'm lazy too. What's up, dieharders? Okay. Well, yeah. That's no problem. We got a couple hours here to do this new language. All right, so yeah, I'm going to start by doing this whole, like, crafting up this text part of it. So letter A, big A, there it is. And the little letter A, actually, maybe I'll just do this. Nah, I should really get all this. List it as text first, the codes for it written first, because then I can switch to my graphics tablet and draw them all. What's up, Rocket Bunny? All right, so we got A down. Oh, I should start doing the hex codes too. And the letter. I wish I had a... I wonder if this is Unicode A or... I don't know, maybe, hopefully it is. Well, let's look at this. I did, I shaved all my hair off. I know, it's so sad, right? Oh, see, they're just using a regular A here. Okay, well, no worries. But I will need the code for it. All right, regular A it is. All right, but what's this code? Is this really 410? What? I'm trying to remember how I did these other ones, like these and stuff. This is ID 357. It's probably just 410 like this. Where did I go for this site again? Or to look up Unicode characters before? This is in decimal. I'm not sure whether this is in decimal or what. Totally, man. Out of 10, you got 420. Oh, man. So I get sad when I think about 420. I wish I could smoke weed right now. One of these days soon, I'll be able to smoke weed again. Hey, okay, all right. This is looking promising. I've been to this website before. All right, good. So here's the little A with the circle on top. That's one of the last characters I added for For Swedish. And here it is. And this became 229. So, and where is it again? Where'd it go? Oh, there it is. Okay, so that is in hexadecimal, the plus E5 or whatever. So that's decimal 229. So is that right? Let's check this out. Calculator 410. In decimal. 410 in decimal becomes 19A. No, 410 in hex becomes 1040. So this should be 1040. Should be up here. Let's confirm this the other way around, starting with the Russian. Excuse me. Yeah, it's pretty hexy up. It's hexy up there, ain't it? Live Dare this weekend, man. All right, 1040. No, 410. 410. Ah, here we go. Starts here. And just to confirm, decimal 1040. Cool. All right, we got it. From now on, I can just refer to this little list. Hover my cursor over here and do the easy. Look it up nice and easy, man. So this is, even though it looks exactly like the English character, it has an ID of 1040. All right. Let's do the little A. This is going to take a minute. It's going to take a minute, that's for sure. So the little a, same thing. It's like exactly the same as the English. And this is 430. Little a, yeah, 430. Cool. Can I copy that? I wish you could copy easily from this. Oh, you can? All right, so 430 is 1072. All right, we got two letters coded up. What's up, Zilton? Mr. Freddy, what's up, man? I love your greetings. What was yesterday's bro, your boats? All right, letter B. I mean, not B, but how does he say this one? You guys got a lot of crazy letters. I love it. So there's two sets of Bs. Wait, there's a lot of kind of B-looking ones, huh? No, there's just a couple Bs. That one kind of looks like a B. All these look like Bs kind of too. But that's okay. We can just start with these first Bs. I'm calling them Bs, even though they probably don't sound anything like a B. You lost your hat after the first death? You did? That shouldn't happen. No. You mean you lost the top hat item after your first death? Or do you mean when you woke back up or whatever, you didn't have a hat on? I'm assuming you mean that you lost the top hat item. You didn't have it in the items. That should not happen. Oh, I would really love to see a video of that. Man. Where did you get it? Where did you get the top hat from? Zilton, you just submitted your game yesterday. Good for you, man. Why are you afraid you're gonna fail? Yeah, Mr. Frank, nice, man. Glad you got to play. No, it's not normal. You should not lose any items. You're supposed to keep all the items you ever pick up, even if you die. Okay, so you got it from the goat-headed dude. You die. Where did you die at? No, you're supposed to keep it. The only thing you lose is your where you are in the world. You have to kind of go back a little bit. So I'm making the Russian alphabet here. All right, so this next one looks kind of like a B. We're gonna have two sets of Bs here. On the first floor of the dungeon. Huh. That is so weird. So you had the top hat, you could throw the top hat. You also had bombs. You could use your bombs, but then when it saved. Wait, Kovarni. I think I know what it was. I think I know what happened exactly. I think you actually have the top hat, it just unequipped it. So check this out. What happens when you whenever you die, the game applies your old equipment in case you had a certain setup or something like that to your equipment, right? So your choices for your equipment. So check it out. If I unequip my top hat, it'll seem like I don't have it or I lost it or whatever, but you actually have it. And it'll be in your inventory. All you gotta do is go back into your inventory and then re-equip it. Oh, you already checked that? Die Harder is cool, man. Oh, I'm glad, dude. I'm so excited for you. Die Harder's just got his Kickstarter funded. Congratulations, man. Super congratulations. Hell yeah, dude. Thanks for stopping by and saying hi. So you only have bombs and a top hat? Nice, Mr. Frenic, I'm so glad. Yeah, there's been a lot of little tweaks to the sword to make it feel even more satisfying. Like, for example, when you swing the sword and you swing it a couple times in a row, you get a little bit of momentum buildup. So if you successfully hit stuff, you can actually have a shorter cooldown every time you swing. You also have a little bit of momentum, so you can kind of keep moving in the direction you're going when you're swinging the sword. It kind of makes it feel nice too. So wait, you said you have only the bombs in the top hat? Kovarni, can you send me your saves file? I mean, is it exactly how it was? Or did you already play through the game and it changed everything? Because if you still have your saves file the way it is, like the way you lost your top hat, send me that. Send me an email with that file and I'll check it out. Okay, so we got a couple B's. Let's get these letters code it up. This is the next B. The big, this is kind of like a B. 1041. And then the little B, 1073. Okay, so it's just going in line. This one's just going to be 1042, and this one's going to be 1074. Oh, it was yesterday? Dang. So wait, Kovarni, were you able to get your top hat again? Nice, Teak. Right on. Mr. Frenick, yeah, I'm definitely, I would love to hear. Please share. These next ones are gonna look like sort of like upside down L's. Oh, I should paste these too. There's that character and this little character. Oh, and we're gonna need to keep these in order. I'm pretty sure that matters in these files. Oh, some of the bloom was too intense. You can turn it off if you want. So there's that adjustment. But I know what you mean. Like you'd want to like dial it back a bit. I think what I'd rather do is actually make it just make it look better, you know? Instead of adding an option to change it so, 'cause you already got the option to disable it. If you just set your quality to okay, there'll be no more bloom, no more blur shader, the shadows are crisp and stuff like that. So you can see there's no bloom. And then if you go, you can turn it back on or whatever. Quality, awesome. That turns back on the bloom. So this, you can see the swords all bright and stuff. So where was it? What exactly, what areas was it too bright in? Oh, okay. Yeah, players being occluded. I hear you on that, but that kind of goes against my design philosophy of this game. I don't want to make it like other games. And almost every single other game, when you go behind something, you can still see yourself, and it bugs me. It's an aesthetic choice. And I think I'm probably going to stick to my guns on that one. My preference in designing this game is to make sure that, or to prefer creating the world so that it doesn't allow too much occlusion, right? Like, you know, this, you can still kind of see yourself. This wall right here, you can still kind of see yourself. So you still know where you are. So that's my preference. My preference is I'd rather go and make it so that the areas don't cover up stuff too much, rather than making it doing the silhouette effect. Yeah, it's a very purposeful design choice. There's so many other games like that that are like action RPGs like this that do that, and it's always bugged me. I don't know why. A penguin with boxing gloves, right on. It's an NPC. Oh, Rocket Bunny, if only you were around during the Kickstarter days. You could have got your own NPC. So we got the big B, little B. These are a little bit different than our Bs. In fact, I think this A might be a little different than our A. I'll go ahead and copy it anyways, even though it's probably the same. Like this little A looks looks exactly the same. How about this big B? See, that looked different. This one too. This is different. It was definitely different there. You like that effect? I hear you. I mean, I'm sure that's, you know. It makes a V noise? I know. I'm gonna say all these wrong today. Oh, good. This one's G, this one's V. Duh. Songbringer. So the next one is kind of like an L. Just take L. But you already have an upside down L? No. Cool. All right. So the L, once again, 1043. Are any of these? No, this is all in order. 1055, 1071. Yeah, all these are in order. I don't need to keep looking these up. I can verify, like, at the end of the rows. I can be like, okay, yeah, this one's 1087 or whatever. Okay, I can stop looking these up. This is going to be 1043, and this one's going to be 1075. And their letters look like this, and this is the G. Man, this is going to be hard to do. This is going to be a lot of work to make this font. Might take a couple hours. All right. Thanks, Mr. Frenick. You'll get better. This next one's duh. So does it really matter that I'm changing the... It doesn't. I should just start copying these like this. Right? How can I make this easiest for myself? All these X's and Y's are going to change. Oh, wait. If I go to the small font, so I got font. Alien font. Oh, yeah, these are exactly the same, aren't they? Aren't they? This is, yeah, brackets, hat, double quote. Yeah. I could just insert the Russian font here. Right? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Damn, I'll need one more character. No, I could just reuse the A. Okay, I could fit it all on this one line. And then, yeah, since I'm fitting it all on this one line, yeah. So, I mean... Yeah, if I keep the Russian font exactly here, and then I go to the alien font and also keep the Russian font here. Or no, I would have to go and make it so the Russian font is here, but I also copy the regular letters over to there from the alien font, but the small font. Oh shit, the small font's different. Damn it. I should make the small font exactly like this one so it's way easier to manage. Or no, the small font is only. Maybe I could just make the small font only English. Yeah, I really shouldn't worry about this being all every single language. Because I only use this for debug and a couple small thing. Well, there's delete and int. Damn it. Maybe instead of using the small font for some of the fonts that I'm using in the game, if it's ever important text, I really should just use this font, this regular font, because I don't want to have to go and duplicate all this work for every single language and do it twice. It's going to take forever if I do. And then the alien font, too. Maybe I can make the alien font smarter somehow. Yeah, I can reuse characters for that. Okay, cool. I got a plan. It took a minute there to plan all this out, but this is a lot of work. So just thinking it through really helps. Why don't you make a console app to build for you the code? That's a good suggestion. I like that. I'm thinking about how much time that would take versus how much time. Because if I just decided that I'm only gonna do this for one of these files, right? So all I would need to do is. Man, yeah, I could just make a little code really fast to export all these. Why not? Shit, let's do it. I'm gonna take your suggestion. We'll do that really quick. I'll still have to go back in and customize every one of these X and Y positions. And widths and heights and X advances, but at least it will give me all 66 lines of code to start with. And it'll be good in the future if I want to do that for Japanese, Chinese, you know, all those. Alright, but what I really need is that the Russian alphabet all in one line. Yeah, I know they're outdated. Yeah. I'm going to go get in touch with all the people that are doing their translations and just to get in touch with them and see. Damn it. I want a list of all the letters as one string. I just want to like copy it. I want all the uppercase letters in 133 letter string and all the lowercase letters together. God, that would make this so much easier. Aye. Ah. Yeah, I don't want to make a custom editor, but if I mean, a couple lines of code to export all these could make it easy. Pixel collision to readjust? No, that's too long. That'll take too long. I don't want to actually read a ping file. No, that'll take way, way too long. This is so much easier just to like, that would be way easier to do it by hand or way faster. Oh yeah. Yeah, I don't know. Just use your go with whatever you think works, man. I trust you. You know Russian. Oh, here we go. Is that right? 33 letters? Says it's line 67. Oh, you're wrong! I can't believe TextMate is that wrong. All right, see you, T. What's up, Leon Hart? I'm using a framework called Cocos 2DX. No, well, it's. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think that's a good use of time. But thanks for. It's a good suggestion. It really is. If I were to do a lot of languages, you're totally right. But it's just too much work because I have to go and custom pixel it anyways, right? I have to draw these little fonts, so it's pretty easy while I'm drawing the font to like, oh. This font is 9 pixels wide, and then just come back once I have it all written, and I can write this is, X advance 10 and width is 9 or whatever. Okay, so this TextMate's wrong about how many characters there are here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. Cool. The next line. Yep, here we go. 33. It's all throw them, all of them. Good, good, good. Cool. All right, we got 2 lines of text. Let's write a little console app that'll just quickly go and export all these. Scope creep. Leonhard. No, it's not exclusive to Mac. It's a cross-platform engine. It's Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, Android, tons of other platforms. See, it's meant to be cross-platform. All right, so let's get our lines of code. What are they called? String 16? I think they're called string 16. 16 string? What the hell are these? String U? Do you need W car or something? Shit. I know it's in the Songbringer CC project. Set BM font. CC label. This will have it. Because labels have. Ah, it's U16 string. Why does it not like that? Yeah, the performance is excellent on all platforms. Oh yeah, you can't initialize const car this way. How the hell do you do this again? Wait, I think you can actually, no, you don't even need to, shit, I don't even need to do this, do I? I don't. I'm pretty sure I could just use string stir. I know I can, yeah. And that'll just store its Unicode values a little bit differently. So, okay, so I'll loop through each one of these. Maybe I should make that a vector of cars. No. Oh, but see, that's the problem, is if I make this a, if I don't make that a U16 string, I won't be able to looping through each character. I feel like I'm wasting time. Oh, can I do this? Oh, there we go. Oh, shit. It doesn't work. Oh, it's you? It's just you? Oh, there we go. I never knew you could do that. Okay, cool. For int I equals 0, I is less than third odd size. And this is the starts at the base of 1040. So the X and Y positions are going to be different. Or actually, no, I can actually do these. Yeah, I can build this into the app. So the X position starts at 0 and then I guess this would be a constant base. The character line width is 16, right? 16. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, yeah, 16. And then each character character width is 16, character height is 15. X offset, Y offset? What the hell are those? I guess I'm not using any of those. All right, no worries. X offset, Y offset. X advance is going to need to be custom for each one. But what's an average? 9 or 10? 9 is pretty average. We'll keep that. Page 0, channel 0, and then lastly, we want the letter, stir I. All right, we can fill in the X and Ys. X is going to be I. Oh, we need an X base. And a Y base. In this particular case, we want the Y base to be If I change the height of this file, it'll mess everything up I've already done. Because this is zero. Wait, is it? Hold on. Is this texture coordinates or... Let's see, the current, for example, the Z with the that on the top is X128, Y210. Y210? Totally, it starts from the top, so I can increase the height of this. That's kind of lucky. I think that's going to be 225. All right, good. Wow, that's cool. Y base 225. So that's going to be the X base plus I times car width. Or wait, no, I mod just make this a int xx equals I mod cars per line and yy is I over cars per line floor. What's up, Kappa? No, I'm working on the Russian language today. So I already worked on bugs this morning. On today's stream, I just want to do Russian. What's up, Blood? Welcome, everybody. Is that math.h actually? Oh yeah, that's math.h. So I want floor f of, let's make this explicit. So this is gonna become the xx times the car width, and this is the y base plus YY times car height. All right, there. We got one. I think it's all done. Let's see if this works. You can help with Russian moral support. Thanks, man. Did that work? Oh, we need new lines. That would be nice. I didn't draw the character correctly. I don't want to do... Oh, so I need to cast that to like a U16? What is this? What is this actually? Car 16T. Still didn't work. You can help too. Thanks, man. Cheers, Blood. Thanks a lot. I will. How do I convert from a U16 to I want this one. So I guess I want to do this. I want to make a converter and then convert. Or I could have made all these. Damn, you know what? I could just make all these. I already know how to code. I already know how Unicode characters work, so I could just do regular strings. Let's do regular strings. Fuck these, man. String, regular string. For the string size, if the string is a UTF-8 character, so if str I. Let's actually get the character. Char C equals str I. If C and OX, what's one shifted up? Will there be a Dutch translation? Yes, there's somebody that committed to doing a Dutch translation. Once again, I got to get in touch with all these people that said they do translations and just check, make sure they're still going to. Oh yeah, 128, which is in hex is 80. That's right. So if C and 80 continue. Oh. We also need a running count then. And this needs to be count, and that needs to be count. Oh man. I hope this turns out to be worth it. I guess I need a space there. And here, oh no, shit, if I do that, then this won't draw the right character. Or will it? It probably won't. If you need help with an English translation? Okay, we'll go back to the UTF-16. Did you ever try to implement a font renderer correctly? It's a huge pain in the neck. No, I've never tried that. You'll do the pig Latin translation? Nice. Steve, what's up, Steve? How about Canadian? Hey, dude, I need help with Canadian. Alright, I'm trying to look up the header. Is it in locale? Oh, it's in code. Gosh, there's a lot of headers for these. Well, oh, thank God, we finally have a converter. All right, so this converts 2 bytes. This takes a UTF-16 string. And converts. So we're going to do something like this to convert down here. So we've got the string. Wait. A U16 string. The 16 equals stir I. Does that work? Doesn't like that. How about S16 plus equals stir I? Okay, there we go. We got it. All right. Now the string S8 equals convert 2 bytes. Using the S16. I think it worked. Please work. Yes, it worked. Nice. I can finally print. I'm printing a UTF-16 character in UTF-8 so I can have all this as it is. All right, let's see if that all fits in so I don't have to type all this. Yay for not having to type stuff. Okay, so we got the ID starting at 1040 going up to 1072. We've got the X starting at 0. Actually, it's not going to start at 0. The X is going to be a little different. Because we're going to offset it and not use the A. It's going to be a little bit different. It might just be easier just to put the A in there anyways. It's Canadian translation can be filled with a bunch of sorries and A's. Yeah, it is. It already is. Yeah, Steve Tramby. So I'm not... The source text is already going to be in UTF-8. I'm just creating a little... I'm creating a font exporter thing. Because there's no tool for this really that works that well. I do have a thing called BM font, which exports fonts, but it's kind of weak sauce. It's not very good for customizing and stuff. Okay, so I put a space in there for those, so we gotta take that out. Run that again. All right, we got 33 characters. I think it probably would it be easier just to skip the A or no, I can export the A or without the A. Too easy, man. Yeah, I'll skip A. So we're going to take. I still want the A character. Oh, basically, I just want to export it again without the A. Oh shit, but then I need to change the base. Wait a minute, does it know the base? Oh shit, it might know the base. That would be cool. Car ID equals int. Stir eye? Does that work? Oh, it does. That's really cool. Because then I don't have to go look all those up. That's pretty nice. Right on. So get rid of this base. We don't need that anymore. And you just copy all this. So starting, we've got the letter A. It's separate. And then we've got all these other ones starting with X, 0. Yeah, this will work. Awesome. Cool. I like it. And you're right. This is good for if I ever do another language like, you know, Japanese, Chinese, Korean. There'll be a lot of characters to be exported and stuff. So I'll have this little utility, which I can use to export all those characters really quickly. And secondly, I'll also have this string ready to go so that I'll be able to test out this code, this lines and stuff like that in the game's data. So I'll export all this as a, you know, a test string and throw it in the game for testing. So I lost my A character accidentally. Whoops. This is a special A. Hopefully, is that special? Oh, it is. Lovely. That's a special A. Special A. Okay, ID starts at 1040. We're gonna have us, let's get the A. There we go. We've got 33 Russian characters. All these lines are ready to go. All I got to do is draw the font now. Next thing we got to do is the lowercase letters. Let's get those. Starting with the A. The lowercase a. Or is it ah? What is it again? Starts at 1072. Yeah, 1072. Luckily, no one understood me. What's up, feared killer? Yuppie? Let's see if all that looks right. 1072. Are all these right? 1040. Da, 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 da. These look all good. Sequential. Looks very sequential to me. 1070 to 1080, 1090, 1103. It ends with 1103. Yeah, 1103. All these characters. They look all right. Okay. All right, so now that we have all that working, let's see, wait, does it, oh, that will just be blank. So if I have, let's get a test string started. Let's close that. Oh, it doesn't matter here. If I just run the game, that font file should change. Born is night. I'm good, Feared Killer. Thanks for asking, man. If you're asking me. This did not update. Why not? Don't tell me. Don't tell me. Okay. Still okay. Why haven't you updated font? Oh, there it is. Okay. Rsync, you, if it, that means if it's updated, I think. Raw font star to assets textures. Why hasn't it changed? What file is this? It's not right. Why isn't that the right file? Thanks, Feared Killer. Cheers, man. Oh, there it goes. I guess it just took it a second. All right, cool. So we got that. Now we can create a test string. Sort of like, What did you say? What? All right, so now I got a string all set up. A bunch of different like lines and stuff. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so yeah, so Rockle saved like a couple different lines here. Now I need a story element for testing this out. Once again, kind of like what? Cool. All right, now I'm gonna run it, and he's gonna say this line, but it's all gonna be transparent at first, because we haven't drawn anything yet. Oh, it's got the A. It does have something. Look, the little A. Cool. That's a good little verification. All right, now that we've got that, we can actually draw the font. Step C. Put your dick in the box. All right. So the first letter. Yeah, I can do that with any language, pretty much, yeah. So thanks, his. It works. It does work, right? So yeah, it's thanks to his suggestion, I made a little app. A quick little, one file app that exports out some lines of code for this font file, because the tools to make the font file are kind of crazy. So then now I just have to go draw it. So this first letter is just like an A, but the next one here is this B thingy. It looks kind of like this. Is that right? Man, the context switching is really getting to me. Well, there's like a curvy end on the bottom. Whoops. It's something. Oh, the drawing part's easy. The drawing part's like the fun part for me. The code part's always the hard, intense, long part. Is that too tall? This is the capital one. It's hard for me to know what aesthetically is the right thing to do here. I think that's pretty good. So a lowercase one is kind of like more squiggly. It's got like a little doop-de-doo on top and like one of these. It's perfect. It's just like that. How to deal with the door? You know how to do it, don't you? So you can see the curvature of the letter? Oh, you mean on the website? Steve Tramby, so BM glyph or BM font, you know, all the font tools or whatever, they just don't, they don't export out the right, first of all, they don't export out, let me show you. They don't export out the right X's and Y's for my font and how I want to do it, right? Because it's all custom. I know I want to have my font exactly like this on this line. Because I want to duplicate it. I want to duplicate the same code for like small font if necessary, and the same code for alien font if necessary. So I got all these different fonts that need to kind of work together. And so the X's and Y's need to be the same. I want the widths and heights to be exactly the same. And also I want every single one of these lines to have a little semicolon and whatever the letter is for that language on the end. So that I know when I'm going in, I have to hand edit it, because BM glyph, BM font, all those things, they really suck at like, well, they don't really suck, but they don't ever give you exactly the right widths and heights and everything for pixel art. You know, this is a pixel art game. One single pixel makes a huge difference. So the X advanced has to be perfect. And there's no way of getting around it other than starting with BM font and then going back in and hand editing every single one of BM font's lines. So it's just easier for me to code it by hand than it is to use BM font or one of those tools. Oh man, context switching is getting me kind of like bleary-eyed. All right, so the bottom is circular and the top has a little loop-de-doo. It needs to be more. I got an idea. I'll use a reference image. Right. Could just use a reference font really quick. Yeah. take back Mal for being your English translator. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. This doesn't look anything like that font online, though. What font is this? Kavarni, yeah, did you already go to the room where that opens up that door, though? Did you go to there's a room that you have to go fight the other dragons in first to open that big door up. Computed. That's just sans serif? Which is like probably Arial or Helvetica or something. There's no like regular sans serif. Helvetica would probably do, or Arial. Let's see what Helvetica. That's better. It looks more like it. What about Arial? I don't know, I think Helvetica was a little nicer. Okay, now we got, this is the lowercase one. I wasn't supposed to be doing that one. I'm supposed to be doing the uppercase B, or the other, va, or whatever. Okay, good to have a little reference. Much better, much better. So this one looks like a B, a lot like a B. Even more like a B than the last one. Darn. Man, all this looking at Unicodes and pixel art is making me crazy bleary-eyed today. This one's really square. I wish I could zoom in, but I don't know how. Yeah, I don't need to. It's like more square on this on the right side. God damn it, what the fuck's going on here? It's got like this little thing there. It's like that kind of. That's an S sound. So this one just looks like a regular E. Dude, what's going on? Alt tab and freaking alt tab's back. Okay, regular E, E with the umlaut. That's a new mod, right? This one's crazy! It's like 2Ks put together! It's yo. This is like my favorite letter so far. Like it. It's looking okay. Dude, seriously, the alt tab jumping me back, so weird. Yeah, okay. Zzz, zzz. An ant without a head. Yeah, it's an ant without a head. It's the most pleasurable letter. Really? The square A's got to be bigger? Oh, yeah, I see how it drops below the line a little bit. Okay, so it's got to go, it's got to be bigger, but like bigger this way. So here and here. Like that, right? Yeah, below the line. Okay. Or maybe nah, yeah, like that. This looks pretty good. So this one is a three. Looks like a backwards three. It looks exactly like a backwards three there too. This one's Z. Z, z. This one's z, z, and this one's z. Interesting language. I feel like I'm learning something today. It's like a Pokemon? Pokemon. Right. Well, these next two are pretty easy. These are the Nine Inch Nails letters. You guys actually have a backwards N. Nine Inch Nails stole their letters from you. Total letter thieves. Oh my God, what's going on here? What? What the fuck? It's killing me, man. It's killing me. Just trying to alt tab. Ay, yi. All right, Z, N. And with a little swoop on top. This one's just a K. It is, just looks like a regular K. So this one looks like it's like a little elephant. It's got an elephant's trunk. Oh my God, I just alt-tabbed and it didn't alt-tab me back. This is like a big elephant. This is a this little baby elephant. Whoa, dang. Holy crap. He's. What is he speaking about? He's saying, well, if it isn't the village idiot, he's saying, like, oh, you're an idiot. Basically. Brutus doesn't like you. Yeah, he's insulting him. Yeah. Oh my God. I'm just trying to work. I'm just trying to alt tab. Why does this shit like this have to happen? Wait a minute. What if I go into full screen mode? And then alt tab. Alt tab's working again! Fucking computers. I gotta say, this one looks a lot like an M. This one's an H. Yeah, village idiot. Yay, Zach. Oh, yeah. Don't put the comma in there. You got it. Yeah. And then it becomes easier to understand. Mr. Frederick. They'll do that. Did it do it on purpose? Your cat's like, I'm pissed off. Gonna show this guy. Show this guy what's up. Oh. Oh. Puh. Brr. T. Did I do these right? Is the last line. This one? Yeah, it is. It's the last character on that line. Cool. And the next line is going to start with the P, or it looks like a P, but it's really a R. Did I get it right? R. You'll just have to survive till uni. Oh, Rocket Bunny. Oh, man, that sucks. Tell me, it gets better. Remember how I told you it's American middle school sucks. Kids are just at this crazy age, man. They're like all being assholes and stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. This isn't right. What did I get wrong here? Is this one letter? Oh, this is one letter here. And what's a C at the end? Yeah, there's no C at the end. What's that? I don't know. We can keep it, I guess. Maybe that was supposed to be there. I don't know. All right, let's start drawing these. We got a P looking like letter. Yeah. Yes. P. Wait, no, this one is. Rrr. Rrr. I don't know what that C is, but the A, I'm just using the other A. I'm using the regular A from English for that. I'm just referencing that part of the art for the A. So that looks like a T, but it's actually, shit. It is T. You guys have the same T that we have. T. Ooh. Ooh. Blood. Yeah, there you go, Zach. Nice. Yeah. Yeah, college is better. You get to choose, finally, at least in the States. So this one is ooh. 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 This one is F. And it looks like the Greek phi. F. Nice. I'm glad the streams are a good time, man. Yeah, right? You come here, there's people that know about programming and games. Isn't it cool? It's hard to find this, really. At least it was for me. I don't know. Maybe you guys have friends that, like, know how to program and stuff, but most of my friends don't know how to program and don't know anything about making games. So it's really nice to come to this and be here on the stream and talk about making games, because I really don't have anybody else to talk about that with. Okay, so this O thing, or this F. Oh, it's the same height as the other characters, But the lowercase one has a really tall. It's like a really tall bar there in the middle. So let's make this like a little bigger. See if we can kind of make it look like this. I think that will look better. Yeah. Oh, cool. So like I just did, right? This larger O. Tell me if it needs to be even larger. X. Wait, no, this is not X. It's ch. Ch. Dooch. Is that dooch? Oh, yeah, delay. Cool. Thanks, man. X. No, ch. Like douche bag? Douche. Or is it, wait, is it lock? Like kuh. Is this kuh? Oh, it is. It's kuh. You just keep quiet about programming? Oh, yeah. You sound like you're pretentious. I got to admit, I sounded like that a lot when I was in high school. I would talk about programming all the time, and people were probably like, this guy is an asshole. He just, like, thinks he's smarter than us. Tss. This one's tss. It's like a drum, but it's you know what I mean? Yeah. Oh, this one's ch. This one's k. K. And ch. You're welcome, bunny. You're gonna get through it, man. You know what, bunny? Better than that, I bet you can find your groove there, right? Find your groove, man. Find your groove. Find a way to love what you're doing and where you are. That looks too much like a four. So it has like a curvy left side. Oh, this is a Hebrew ka or Dutch ka? Hello? Oh, hello? I'm trying to do, that's my Russian accent. Hello? Hello? It's like a really soft K. Does that look good for this one? What is this one? Ch. Oh, God. Space bar. This one's sh. Or it's not a K at all. Oh, it's not a K at all. Okay, it's just H. H. Hello. I can hexadecimal my way out of any situation. We're stuck inside. Hex my way out. So this one is like a W, but it sounds like a sh. 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 This one's almost the same thing. Oh, wait, but it looks like that. This one's sh, and this one's sh. Sh. I don't know. That sounds like a polite cough. Wait, what am I supposed to do with this translation? The X's sound is like if you put your tongue where you would to make a K sound in English. Oh, yeah. Except you don't actually touch your tongue, your soft palate, and push air past it. Oh, I got it, right? Kinda. Probably doesn't sound right. Nano, real programmers use Emacs. Real programmers use Vim. They use Ed. They use Cat. A magnetized needle and a steady hand. Butterflies. Yeah, I've seen this one before. This one's great. XKCD is awesome. You can never have enough of this, man. Of course, there's an Emacs command to do that. Oh, that was Google. Go to Google Translate, right? Ha ha ha. Let me try that.
Ha ha ha.
She's going too fast for me. It's like a Spanish J. Yeah, yeah. Jose. So how do you make this one sound? The ch, or I mean, sh ch, or sh. I don't know. This one's a B. Wait, no, it's like a called hard signs. This is silent. This is a silent letter. Wow, you guys have a silent letter. Oh, fucking space bar. All right, so this is like kind of like that other. Looking like a B thing, but with a thing on the top there. Is that too small? Oh, so wait, this one's small, this one's tall. So this one will have to like get, I think this is all right. Maybe if I, actually maybe it should be a little wider. Like that. Oh no, you missed the final game. Sounds like a three. What word was that? You were trying to explain it to your wife? Yeah? You can't explain it? Alright. Alright. This one is a like the other one, but it's like two letters almost together. So are they supposed to touch? I'm imagining they're not touching. It's like a wait. So we got this. And that together. Wait, isn't this like just like the other one? Oh, the other one had a hat on top. All right. Yeah, they're not touching. That's what she said. A GG? A ZZ? Oh, this one's like a Z? Wait. I did this other B pretty wide. So I should probably do these ones similarly wide. Like at least that wide. Eh, this one's eh. It's like a backwards euro. Probably more like this. Wasn't there another one that kind of looked like that? Oh, this, that was just three-ish one. You're speaking in French but trying to do a German accent? Are you scared or? Oh no! Wait, what does this one look like? Aye. Over here. Oh, it's got a really big circular part. Looks all right. Try to translate this without translate. My programming is so much better than yours. Did I get it right? I'm probably not right at all, huh? Wow, seeing a backwards R really messes with my head. Yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah, man, somewhere along the line I think I got a little bit shorter than the other ones. Oops, oops. Hold on, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are all 8. I think I made these too tiny. Yeah, it needs to be a pixel taller. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, that also means I. Huh. Oh, it's... Wait, what did they... Oh, yeah. Oh, I said ja, because I was looking at this J over here. Yeah. Yeah. How do I do that one? I guess I would do one pixel lower to kind of stay with the rest of the style of the font. Oh yeah, IPA. Azimus, what are we getting the Klingon translation? Well, I need somebody to translate into Klingon for me. But shit, how? What are? Is Klingon? Does Klingon have a lot of characters? I don't got too much time to draw all these characters, man. Too many characters in all these languages. Is that right? How's this? It's like a really big O, but it's not really a big one of those. It's like a more like this, maybe? No. Or that. Actually, it needs at least another pixel. Oh, my programming skills are better than your face. Verstappen is the best formula in Bister the world. Verstappen is the best Formula One driver in the entire world. On your face. Woo! Got it all! Alright, let's export this. Whew, man, my eyes are going crazy. I'm like, ah! I can't say, ah! Okay, let's see how this looks though before I stop the stream, because I'm definitely gonna have to stop the stream soon. Take off this background. Wait, oh, this is all. We can just turn that off there. And then re-export this. Font.png. Sheet. No, raw. Fonts. Save. Replace and rebuild. Rerun. Whoa. There's another C. Oh, I gotta draw a custom A because that A is too short. Oh, either that or I should make all the freaking Russian letters a little shorter. Oh, what should I do? I don't want to redraw all those. I guess I should make another A. Is there another C, really? Where's the C at? It's not in here. It's not here either. Were you talking about the sea? A sea mission? Oh, did I get, wait, you mean the sea from the beginning here? This one? Oh, it's right here. It's right there. Oh, you know what? I think I actually should take a pixel off of the top of all these. They'll all look a lot better. The font will just look so much better in the game. And I think it'll still be readable. Oh, yeah, the Photoshop. I don't know what the hell that C was on the Photoshop reference. Yeah. Snow or beaches? It depends on the kind of type of year, man. Or it depends on the season. Because right now, I would definitely say snow. But most of the time, I would say beaches. Space my name. What's up? Oh. There's a, the Y looks, okay. The Y, huh? Let's look at that. It says it looks like a, so it needs like more of a tail down here, I mean? Like it should look like that kinda? Is that better? Ooh, sorry, it's ooh. Did I get it wrong? Is it still bad? It's like this maybe? Oh, so, okay, so this part's taller and that part's little. Like that? Is that better? Looks a little better. So now these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I don't know how to zoom my webpage, though. I know there's a command in Mac, but I don't know what it is. I think this one needs to stay big, though, right? We'll keep that one a little taller. Is it command scroll? No. I know it's like option. It's like, I don't know how to do it. Just looks a lot better, so much better. Oh, like pinch, spread, zoom. Oh, command plus, command minus. Oh, see, that looks so much better. Just that one little pixel difference. And you can still read it. Oh, okay. So more. More like this. Does that look better? What's up, Wiseman? Better? Oh, okay, cool. Alright, cool. Well, man, shit, how long have I been streaming? 2 hours, 2.5. I'm already way over my time. I gotta take a break. I must rest. Wizard food needs rest. But before I go, is it cool? Does it look okay if I take this one and go like that? I think it does. That's, now it's the same width as that P. I think that'll really help that letter look a little better. Oh! The A's up there at the top with the regular English letters. I just used that. That's too wide? Okay. Like that? Yeah, that looks pretty good. It looks better. Buffo's here! What's up, Buffu? Good, yay! Right on. Cool. Well, I'm glad we got 33 Russian letters drawn. Well, 32 Russian letters drawn. I just used the A from English. So yeah, later on tonight, what I'll do is I'll draw I'll draw the other letters and I'll send you I'll send you this file so you can like approve it and see like maybe you got some more suggestions. Like when I draw the lowercase letters, I'm sure I'll mess a few of them up and you can provide a few suggestions or whatever and I'll make it better. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. And then yeah, I'll be back tomorrow. So thanks a lot for all your help, you guys. Big shout out to Kovarni for translating it into Russian. Thanks a lot, Kovarni. And for everybody else who's translating too, appreciate you all. And for all the backers and all the people that pre-ordered, thanks a lot. And I hope you all are enjoying playing the game. So, see you, everybody.